Abstraction versus realism in art. In art, we have something called abstraction, which is to reduce something to its most basic elements or forms, such as color, shape, texture, and composition. As seen in this image of a lemon, which is reduced to a series of ellipses. And in this image of a surfer, which is reduced to a stick figure. We will now discuss color in terms of abstraction. There are warm colors and there are cool colors. Warm colors are typically associated with happy feelings, where cooler colors are typically associated with sad feelings. Similar to that, light colors are typically associated with happy feelings, and dark colors are typically associated with sad feelings as well. Colors are complicated and express many different emotions when used in different contexts and when used with different shapes, textures, and forms. Seen here are two different paintings by J.M.W. Turner. In the first, we see gray, muted tones being used, which can convey a sense of distress or worry. And in the second painting, we see pastel tones being used and brighter colors representing the sky, which conveys a happier, more peaceful feeling. This shows us how complicated colors can be in conveying emotion and how we can use them to convey our own feelings. We will now discuss shapes. Shapes are the most basic reduction of something. You can have geometric shapes and organic shapes. And additionally, when drawing shapes, they can be very 2D and flat, as seen in this image, or 3D by adding shading. And then we have texture. Texture helps give drawings more information. As seen here, the different lines and their qualities and their shapes and the feelings they convey all carry different messages, meanings, and purposes in your drawing. And something as simple as a line has a lot of descriptive quality, as seen here, where a hard, dark line is contrasted with a softer, lighter line. Now I will demonstrate how these shapes can be turned into symbols and realistic drawings. In the cloud example, we have an oval, which has been turned into a symbolic cloud, which has been turned into a more realistic, textured drawing. I hope that this video has helped you to understand how we can go from shapes to symbols to realistic imagery, and how we can use this knowledge to help inform and improve our drawing skills. Thank you so much. See you next time.